Hey guys, Ken here at Fox Airsoft with another Tech Talk video. Today we're going to be talking about shimming your gearbox. Shimming is one of the most important aspects of tuning your AG simply because it provides the gears with the greatest strength possible, keeps them from wobbling around, and keeps the surface contact of the teeth at its max. So, you're going to start by opening your gearbox. Remove your entire gear set, as well as all previous shims. A razor's helpful for getting those stuck shims off the face of the gear. All right. Once you have all your shims off, go ahead and get a good bit of the grease off the gears. Make sure you clean out the sector gear teeth, all that good stuff. Clean out that old dirt and grime. And again, cleaning the grease off of your gearbox shell. Just like that. All right, so when we start shimming, we want to start with our spur gear, which is the middle gear in the train. Fits right into this slot here. So you can see when I spin this, you can hear there's a little bit of rubbing on the bevel gear bushing here. So I'm gonna take a 0.01 millimeter shim. We'll start with that on the underside of this gear. Looks like that's going to give us the clearance we want over those other two bushings. So we're good on our spur gear for our base. Next, we'll go with the sector gear. And the big thing with the sector gear is we want to make sure we kind of shim it low as possible and keep it in contact with the spur gear teeth without rubbing on the lower face of the spur gear. We also want to make sure that we're not rubbing on the face of the cutoff lever, causing extra wear and resistance there. Height's actually not bad right now. I am gonna throw, again, a 0.01 millimeter shim on the bottom of this sector gear. All right. Looking pretty good there. Finally, the bevel. Again, same process. Make sure we're not rubbing on any faces. Like we're moving kind of slow there, so we'll go ahead and throw 0.01 millimeter on there again, give that a shot. And now you can see we're spinning a whole lot smoother. So from there, we want to go ahead and screw our gearbox shell together. As you can see, I'm using an ICS split V2 lower gearbox, just for sake of illustration, so that you guys can really see what the gear spinning should look like. This will look the same for just about any gearbox, regardless of design. Just snug it down like you typically would. Just install your gear set, no need for trigger switch, cylinder assembly, or anti-reversal latch. Alright, so after we got screwed together, our gears are spinning pretty well. So we got good rotation there. However, we have a lot of play up and down on these gears. So I'm gonna take a look at these gears and just guess what kind of shimming we're gonna need on each when we go ahead and pull this back apart and add more shims to the top of the gears. It's looking like just about all these are going to need somewhere in the range of 0.5 millimeter shims. Right. go ahead and start with that. Just see how tight we are. As you can see, shimming's really a bit of experimentation. Just going one revision to the next, just to try and find that perfect balance. So again, we're gonna go ahead and snug down our gearbox shell, just as we normally would. And we're actually still spinning quite well. So we're gonna check these gears again for play. Our sector gear, very little play, really nice shimming there. The spur gear, probably about a 0.1 millimeter again. And our bevel about the same as our spur, 0.1 mil. Go ahead and take it apart one more time here. And 0.1 mil. Our spur and bevel. Give that a try, see where we're at. All right, so we're still spinning nice and smooth. Full contact on all of our gear teeth. Really working nicely here. Took out that play on the spur gear, still a little bit, but nothing we're gonna fix with shimming. Totally acceptable. And our bevel gear, same deal, perfect shimming. So, that's what we like. Good 4 or 5 rotations on steel bushings, just the spin of a finger. Just what we're looking for. So now that we have our play set correctly, we're gonna go ahead and move our bevel gear around a little bit. Now the trick with the bevel is getting it to sit just right with the pinion gear on your motor. So in order to do that, typically you wanna shim it to about mid-height in the gearbox shell. So I'm actually gonna go ahead and swap this 0.01 from the top side down to the underside of the gear. Just to raise the gear up a little bit, get it more into that midway point. And we still maintained good full contact with our spur gear on our bevel gear teeth. I'm gonna go ahead and shut this just one more time. All right, still spinning smooth and beautiful, just like we want. Next thing I'm gonna do is go ahead and install our motor. Again, different for every gun design. This is gonna differ highly depending on which model you're working on. I'm working on an M4 today, so I'm gonna go ahead and install the grip. All right. So now that I have my grip installed, I can actually see, can't see it on the video, but ICS actually cuts a window into their gearbox shells prior to, in the factory. And the purpose of that window is so that you can see the pinion gear and bevel gear mesh in here. You can widen this to get a little bit better view, and you can cut it in any gearbox that really doesn't have it already. It doesn't hurt the structural at all, but it does give you that opportunity to get a better view of the pinion and bevel mesh there. From here, I'm gonna go ahead and tune my motor by eye here, my motor height, to make sure that I'm getting the best possible mesh on my bevel and pinion gear. And that looks about right there. So again, can't see it on the video, but what you're looking for is for the backside of the pinion gear teeth to line up with the edge of the bevel gear. Get that full contact once again. And you know, shim your bevel up and down from there, or your motor back and forth to get that perfect best mesh. So we'll go ahead and throw a trigger switch in this guy so you guys can hear the results. Make sure, you know, we don't have any squealing or whining or anything like that. And show you guys just what a good shim job can do for the sound of your AEG. Alright guys, so we just got this wire harness installed, got our motor in, tuning's good, so I'll let you guys hear here. No real squeals or anything, little chatter between the gear teeth, nothing unusual. So our shimming's good, motor tuning's good, and this thing is ready to be built the rest of the way. So if you guys have any more questions about shimming your own AEGs, give us a call or shoot us an email at foxairsoft.com, and we'll see you next time.